So I've been shooting some properties during COVID. I've been helping out different real estate agents on listing their houses, taking photos and video. I'm gonna share with you some things that I've learned and a few things that I've seen in other agents' videos that are missing. So problem number one is the videos are too long. Depending on how big the house is, the videos are often too long, causing the viewer to lose interest and not fully watch the whole video of the house, because that's why you want them to watch the videos, to look at the house. So another thing I've seen is repetitive clips. It's using the same clip over and over again. And this, to me, shows a lack of professionalism and confusion. Going back to the first thing, you want to make them nice, short, quick, and to the point. I would say at the end of the video, you want the person to just see enough to have the people call the agent that you're working for so that they can actually go and see the house. Because it's always best to see the house in person, but you give them just a little bit of a nugget and it's like, I'm gonna go check out that house. I'm gonna call this next one storytelling. I'm not sure exactly what else I would call it. So I'm gonna call it storytelling. And that is, so maybe they'll start off with like a drone shot on the outside, you know, showing off the outside. Maybe it's on a golf course or something, so you're doing a nice, you know, parallax of the outside. And then it jumps inside. It shows off the dining room. Then it jumps back outside. And then you're in the basement. And now you're in a bedroom. Now you're looking at a bathroom. Maybe you jump back outside again to maybe a clip that doesn't even show the house. And then the video's over. And it's like, wait, what did I just watch? Probably wondering, okay, you've told me these problems. How do I fix them? I'm gonna tell you. I'm gonna tell you right here. I'm gonna tell you right here, right now, right here. Here we go. All right, number one, shoot with a purpose. They call this shoot to edit. This basically means shoot your project with the edit in mind. When I go into a house, as I get to each room, I say to myself, okay, how can I show this room off in about 2 to 3 seconds? Angle do I have to be at? What motion can I add? You always want to add some kind of motion. You want to feel like you're walking through the house. So I usually do some kind of push-in movement or some kind of natural parallax movement. You want to add some depth as well to make it look more cinematic. I've seen a huge difference in my own shooting when I've started to add layers to the video. So you'll have your foreground, your background, and your midground. Number two, I guess that is number two. Look at quality instead of time. So don't be like, okay, I got to make this video 5 minutes long. No, if you can do the same thing, show off the 1800 square foot house in a minute and 30 seconds, go for it. Like I said before, give the viewer that little nugget of what does this house look like to then call the agent, to then set up an appointment to actually look at the house. You don't wanna be too short. You don't wanna try to do that 1800 square foot house in 10 seconds. That's a little too short, but you don't want it to be 5 minutes. So kind of feel it out. Final tip is when I do a house, I always pretend I'm seeing this house for the first time. So how would I wanna see it? So by that, I mean in the edit, start off with a nice shot of the outside, showing it off, and maybe a few yards of the backyard, the front yard, you know, other houses around it. Then you come inside, you open up the front door, because that's how you would start a tour with the house. You don't go in through the garage or something. You start in the front door, show off whatever is in the front door, maybe go to the living room, the kitchen, you know, maybe a den, if they have a den, start going into some bedrooms, maybe some bathrooms that have something interesting about it. Always ask the agent, do they want to show off the bathrooms? Also, before I even say that, always ask the agent, what are some key features of the house that you want to show off? The garage, is it the pool, is it a gym, is it the view, what is it? So you can make sure to capture that first. Okay, those are my three tips. Those are my three solutions to the problems that I've seen in real estate video. Hope this was able to help you guys. Yeah, another thing that I got a lot of inspiration from, training from, was Parker Wallback, full-time filmmaker. I got into that course and just looked all the real estate stuff, and that helped me a lot. So I hope this was able to help. I want to start making more videos like this. What do you guys think of this setup? I think I like it pretty nice. It looks pretty good. I'm not sure how much longer I'll have this space for, but I'll make as many videos as I possibly can here. So yeah, hope you guys enjoy it. See you next time.